to stay out of that ring.
That's true, Killer. You know, this team is so much fun to be the world tag team champions that they just stop with nothing to do. They're in against a real great veteran right now, the woman that can take on four or five that she needs to, and that's Misty Blue Sims.
The only good thing is, at least I'm glad to see Eddie Sharkey's not refereeing this man.
Well, Eddie is a capable referee, but the last couple matches I kind of questioned his integrity.
No question. Well, right now, as you said, Mr. Blue is as crafty and as capable as they come. And she's so far not letting Nasty Cat get any upper advantage.
A little secret out of the bag, I've helped train Misty myself too, so.
Well, you know, I was gonna ask you, she comes out of Glens Falls, New York. That's not too far from where you reside part of the time up in Connecticut when you're not hanging around the barracks in Paris Island.
That's right. Misty and I get into the ring quite a bit. She's a really well-versed woman in that ring and knows all the moves.
My only question is, Sergeant, you taught her the Cobra Clutch.
No, I haven't taught her that one yet.
Well, right now, Nasty Cat not wanting very much to do with Misty Blue Sims. And keep a watchful eye on Nasty Linda down at ringside. Look at that. Just pulls her right across by the hair. Made no bones about it. The thing that I don't like about the Nasty Girls, right now they don't seem so much intent on winning a match as just figuring out as much hurt as they can on their opponents right now. That's exactly what I'm talking about. You see Nasty Linda at ringside.
Well, they're just, their minds are completely on those World Tag Team Championships. When they're in single matches like this, I don't think they really care about the rule book. They can't win that title by breaking every rule in the book and getting disqualified.
Now, Sarge, how do you go about trying to prepare for a match like that when you know the rule book, yeah, there is no rule book, they'll do anything, including using those sticks they carry in the ring. Now, there again, there's Nasty Linda going out doing some damage to Misty Blue. Now, Misty Blue heads out after her.
Well, the only way to prepare for the Nasty Girls is climb in the closet with a couple of mad cats and fight your way out.
Either that or try and get somebody to come out the ring. Now, there again, right away, Nasty Linda's got that stick. Now, you got two on one. Now, look exactly what's going on.
Fans helping out Misty there. Misty's really got the fans behind her.
They do. They really like her. She comes in and gives it all she's got. And I tell you, all you have to say is she's been trained in part by one Sergeant Slaughter, and that kind of tells you what kind of ability she has.
Well, I've trained a lot of men in my life, and it's nice to see some of the ladies that I've been training come to the top of the ladder in the world of women's professional wrestling.
There you see Nasty Linda still carrying that stick around, and here at ringside. And she may have done that.
She's a smart, smart lady in that ring.
Hoping to get the cat to make a mistake. Whoa! Take a look at that. Caught in the third form of a flying DDT.
I'd like to see Misty possibly get herself a manager to keep some of this outside interference.
Well, if you're a mind, we might be well excuse you here from ringside for a minute or two. I don't think Nasty Linda or Nasty Cat will want to tangle with you, buddy.
Well, they got Misty Blue Sims' dandruff up here. She's starting to tear the clothes off of this Nasty
Cat. Take a look right there. There again, Nasty Linda just takes her hair, pulls her right into the ropes. I don't know if you want to get now. Misty Blue says, all right, you want to wrestle? Come on in the ring. I'll take you both down. Let's get you both in. Now, there again, she's distracted. Nasty Cat comes up from behind to gain the upper hand. I think the LPWA needs to take some serious looks at when the Nasty Girls are wrestling in single matches. The other one has to stay back in the dressing room.
Well, they just got to tell the referee to take better control of the match. That's what they got to do.
Now, Nasty Cat goes up on that second row, flies off, and she catches Misty Blue. But look at that. Misty throws her right off.
That was a tremendous move by Misty.
I think she just took the flow right with her. And Cat goes right back to work on those boots.
You see, she's using the rope to the advantage of the Nasty Cat.
trying to set her up. I think she's trying to get her in a figure four. And she's just about there.
I've been in this one with Misty at the training camp.
And now look at that. She turns her right around. She's got a half Boston Crab. She's got a half Boston Crab. And you talk about the pain in the lower back. Now take a look. Here's what's happening. Nasty Cat's trying to reach out for Nasty Linda. She caught the rope, referee had to order the break.
She definitely slowed Nasty Cat down on that one. That's what you gotta do sometimes with these tough lady wrestlers, is slow down. She didn't slow down for long, though.
No, she certainly came right back. You gotta give the Nasty Girls credit, like them or not. Well, I'll tell you, they were battling it every inch of the way. She tries to wrap her up, tries to catch her in a little package, small package.
Standing on their feet for this one. All over the ring, there is action. You've got Beverly Shaden, Despina Mantegas, there's Robin Lane, Ning, Despina Mantegas, Luna, Charlie Haynes, Locke, Beverly Shade, Peggy Patterson, Candy Devine, bodies everywhere. And the winner of this battle royal gets a $10,000 payoff. Lady Satan pulling the Prince's main squeeze. Charlie Haynes by the hair over to the ropes. Everybody is paired off and they're all trying to maneuver each other over the top rope. That's 8 feet to the concrete, four below. Candy Devine spins Lady Satan off. Ooh, right hand, another one. Lady Satan is taking some tremendous punishment from Candy Devine in the corner. Meanwhile, Luna and Robin Lane are rolling around choking each other in the other corner. There's Donna Day, Snapmare, and Charlie Haynes. Day pushing Haynes into the corner. Mantegas and Beverly Shade are there. Peggy Patterson, Locke, and Candy Devine in the far corner. No one has been eliminated yet from this battle royal. Peggy Patterson delivering a strong right hand. Here's Donna Day crushing blows on Charlie Haynes. Robin Lane and Luna. Here comes Locke to her aid of her partner. 10 girls in the ring. No one's been eliminated yet. Charlie Haynes and Donna Day getting into it. Beverly Shade in the corner. Bodies all over the ring. Everybody's scratching and biting and kicking and fighting. The Daughters of Darkness beating up on Robin Lane. And actually, they hit Robin over the head with a foreign object. Biting Robin Lane on the ear. Down comes Luna on top of Robin Lane again. Beverly Shade trying to lift Donna Day over the top rope, and Robin Lane going over. Donna Day goes out. Donna Day, the first one to be eliminated by Beverly Shade. Over in the far corner, Luna and Locke. Now Locke breaks away. Peggy Patterson goes down. Candy Devine right on the top rope. She's almost over the top, and she is fighting to stay up. Despina Mantegas is trying to push her down. Robin Lane kicking Beverly Shade. Luna and Locke in the far corner. Luna up on the top rope, and Luna and Locke are actually fighting each other in that corner. They're slapping each other. This is unreal. The Daughters of Darkness are having their own battle royal. Locke perched up on top of the ropes. Now Luna snapmares Peggy Patterson, and Luna and Locke going after each other again. Luna and Locke are having their own battle royal. This is unbelievable in the corner. They're fighting each other. Oh, down goes Locke, straight down. Luna right behind her, unbelievable. Beverly Shade going for a stroll over the top rope. When the tough get going, so does Beverly. Candy Devine and Despina Mantegas. Mantegas picks up Devine right by the neck and bends her over the top rope. Right over the top rope and is choking her. There's no referee in the ring. There's no rules in the battle royal. Robin Lane, bye-bye Robin. Despina Mantegas over the top rope. We're down to two girls just like that. Peggy Patterson and Candy Devine. Arm dragged by Candy Devine. Remember, there is no referee in the ring. Rules do not count. The only rule is being thrown over the top rope. Unbelievable in this battle royal. 10 girls, then there was 9, and all of a sudden there's 2. Candy Devine and Peggy Patterson both going for the $10,000 grand prize. Patterson, very, very big, 195 pounds. Going to be tough for Candy Devine to throw her over the top rope. And Peggy Patterson looks like she has the advantage right now. Candy the Body Devine in trouble. Back with a couple of right hands, and Candy is going for it too. Out goes Peggy Patterson. She did not go over the top rope. She did not go over the top rope. She is not eliminated. Boogaloo Brown, her manager, is out there. He's not supposed to be at ringside. No managers are supposed to be at ringside. The Prince had to be restrained before the start of this. Boogaloo Brown's not supposed to be out there either. All he's going to do is distract, and that's what he's doing right now. He's up in the ring apron. He shouldn't be there. Peggy Patterson charges. Peggy Patterson, Candy Devine! Peggy Patterson is eliminated. Candy Devine is the winner.
She is certainly a very attractive, very educated lady. She was kind of a surprise. She wasn't what I expected to be in professional wrestling. She could almost be a model. She's got to work it out for her. Judy Martin.
Well, she's got her hands full right now. Judy Martin, because if anybody can spoil the debut, Judy Martin.
I don't know, referee Jesse Hernandez, I think wrongfully accusing Keena Moretti of pulling some errors. She was just backing to the end of the rope. Judy is trying to... the gal from California man. Tina's more than ready to have a test of strength. There's that kick.
Put a finger on what's happening here against Tina Moretti.
I think Judy may have taken Tina a bit lightly. By the way, these matches are a presentation of the Ladies Professional Wrestling Association Incorporated in a rebroadcast and reproduction without the express written consent of the LPWA is prohibited. Judy now turns to Jessica into an arm bar and gives her a shot right in that shoulder shot.
Then you're going to see Tina Moretti get a little bit tougher. I'm going to introduce Tina Moretti to Raw Professional Wrestling right now.
She missed. Judy Martin